Alistair, what a moment. You obviously won the Ashes before, but first time as England captain. What was that like on the field in the huddle? Tell us about that.
Yeah, there was a lot of screaming going on. And just a lot of relief, I think. You know, 300 due on that kind of wicket, you should defend, but when they're 120 for one, you know, they played extremely well to do that. Chris Rogers and David Warner. You just have that nagging thought in the back of your mind. Now, is it not going to be? But you know, the way that we responded after a tee, we regrouped as a side and obviously brought in Brezzy really in that part, in the way they bowled, was exceptional.
Were there tense moments as a captain when that is the situation and not much was happening with the ball? Did you have a few butterflies?
No, I think, you know, we kept telling ourselves that, you know, we were two wickets away. If you always had, when you're chasing those kind of runs, you always. You know, you always think if you were batting, you think if we lost a couple of wickets now, what it looked like, and that's what we kept clinging to. You know, it wasn't looking quite that likely at some stage, but and then obviously Broadie got on a roll, and two became five very quickly. So and then it was just not a matter of time, but we felt pretty much in control.
And a big decision, obviously, you also put Bresnan on. It looked like the ball was just starting to reverse at that stage, and of course it produced a key wicket.
Yeah, I mean, you know, obviously Swanee to left-handers is, you know, he's got a fantastic record, and. You know, we just felt a little change-up, you know, sometimes work, and, you know, that was the start of it. You know, a very good ball as well.
And Stuart Broad, obviously, you briefly mentioned him, but when he's on that role, he's done that before, but that seemed almost a level above today, it felt.
Yeah, again, I think I've said that was the goodest bowling I've seen a couple of times with him, and, you know, that was fantastic. And actually, that spell between both of them, you know, we're creating pressure from Brezzy, you know, bowling into the wind and not too much happening for him and creating a lot of chances with Broad in. Yeah, that was fantastic bowling and, you know, a real good team effort. It's a bit of a scrappy game. You know, these low scoring games can be a little bit scrappy, but we won the crucial moments at crucial times.
He lost out on man of the match, but Ian Bell's innings was absolute class apart, wasn't he, in this match?
Yeah, it was. You know, in the past he might have been accused of scoring pretty runs, you know, but my word, in this series all 500 his runs have been totally when the team had needed him the most, and, you know, he can take a lot from that, and, you know, he can take a, you know, go to bed tonight knowing that he's made a massive contribution to England.
And finally, obviously one test match still to go, you want to end the summer on a high. Is it a different feeling going to that final test knowing you've won the series, you won the Ashes?
Yeah, maybe we'll get there, but we know how important the test match is, you know, and the beauty, I suppose, in this test series, you know, we haven't played quite as well as we'd liked at certain times. Now the challenge is to try and get that standard as high as we can, and there's certainly no reason why in the Oval we'll be taking it easy. We've got the chance of winning 4-0, and that's what, you know, we're going to go through.